Alright, so we are back from K-Town. I just went into H-Mart. They wouldn't let us film in there, but I did want to show you guys a little bit of a grocery haul in K-Town. Let's see, I bought a lot of good stuff, and I'm actually going to be making some really delicious food tomorrow. Josh and Sienna are coming over again for dinner tomorrow. It's been really nice just to have them around, just to kind of show us and make us feel at home here. But we're gonna have a Korean feast tomorrow, and I'm gonna be making sundubu, so I'll definitely show you guys how to make that tomorrow. But in the meantime, here in my first bag, I have some bones. These are just frozen beef bones that I'm just gonna boil up to keep a constant pot of bone broth at all times. My hair is actually starting to fall out from the hormones, and I'm at about the 4-month mark after pregnancy, after having baby. So I'm starting to shed like crazy, and I heard that the collagen from the bone broth will really help with keeping the nutrients here and hopefully not shed as much. And then also for the guys, they got this height beer, which is really funny because it has an LA Dodgers on there. I wonder what it would be like if we found one with San Francisco Giants here. I'd probably get jumped. And then some soju. And we have some spicy pork bulgogi. This one I usually make on my own, but I asked Josh and Sienna, and they said they usually just buy it already made. So I said, okay, fine, let's just go with that, since I'm still kind of getting settled and we don't have everything yet. So we just went with this. And then for any Korean barbecue, what I like to do is wrap it in lettuce. So here we have an organic red leaf lettuce that I'm gonna be wrapping with that. One of the things that Josh really recommended for Korean barbecue, you know how when you go, they always have the banchans and then they have the dipping sauces? I usually just do gochujang and the soybean paste, but he told me, no, that's not how you eat it. So I'm learning new things already. We got this soybean seasoned paste. That is what they normally use. Let's see, shall I open it for you guys? So this will be so good to add to the Korean barbecue. I'm gonna layer lettuce leaf, some of the sauce, and then the meat, and then usually they do it with a thin slice of garlic in there too. Oh, I can't wait. My mouth is already watering. And then I'm in charge of making sundubu tomorrow, and I'm also gonna show you guys how to make it, so don't worry. But I got these radish. These are called mu, and I'm gonna make gakdagi with it, which is like Korean radish kimchi. Yeah, I'll be filming so much content here, you guys. Gonna give you the recipe for that too. One of you guys asked me how to make the seaweed salad, and I'm probably gonna put that together with the gakdagi, the soybean kimchi banchan, which I also got here. And then the night before we left Bay Area, I DoorDashed Korean food, and they had really good banchan. They had banchan with the Korean peppers. It's not too spicy, but they just mixed it with a little bit of sesame seed oil and gochujang, and it was so good. So I'm gonna try to recreate that myself too. So here is my little banchan pile. Then we have marinated beef ribeye steak. So this is just your traditional bulgogi with that like Korean barbecue marinade. Sorry, I'm just pulling everything out as I go, so nothing here makes any sense right now. But I also got dried dashi anchovy. This will be great for the soup broth for sundubu. The great thing about H-Mart is that they already have pre-made bone broth. Look how gelatinous it is. Like, you can even hear it. It's like jello. But this is so good, you guys. I just went to have like the best seolleongtang of my life, and I already want more. Definitely I'm gonna go back to that place. But in the meantime, I usually make my own bone broth with these soup bones right here, but it takes like a full day, and I love the convenience of this. It's only $3.49 for this thing, so I definitely want to try and see how flavorful and delicious it is. The good thing about making your own bone broth is that you can make a giant vat, like, and then I can freeze my own, but I like the convenience here, and I definitely do want to try out to see if it's good or not. And then I was so excited to see this Korean rice punch. It's called shikye. Am I saying that right? Shikye? I first had this at Arirang, if you guys remember my vlog, my chow out in Cupertino. They introduced me to shikye and I loved it so much. But then I saw online the recipe and how long it takes to make it too, and I was like, nah, nah, nah. But then they have it sold here. This giant thing was only $2.49, so sometimes it's just better to buy it and save time. And then the last two items are my organic soon tofu. This is for the soon dubu. I love how it comes in this little pouch right here, but all I have to do is just cut the top and then spoon it in. It's like super duper soft. It's almost like double silky tofu. It's gonna be so delicious. But yeah, tomorrow I'm gonna be making some beef soon dubu, and then we're gonna be grilling the pork bulgogi and the beef bulgogi and have a major Korean feast. We're having our first Sunday supper with family. Josh and Sienna are here and we have adopted them. They are stuck here every Sunday from now on. But we're just having legit Korean barbecue at home. I made soon dubu. We just bought the marinated meats from H-Mart, and then I made rice, there's lettuce, samjang, soon dubu, and I made banchan. We bought the kimchi, but then I made cucumber pickles, this spicy Korean green peppers. I had it at Jangsujang at home and I didn't know what was in there, so I kind of just came up with my own recipe. It's samjang, gochujang, a little bit of vinegar, sugar. It's not bad. And then we have the soybean sprouts kimchi. Bon appetit! Or how do you say it in Korean?
Bon appetit, 맛있으세요.
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 맛있으세요. I made a soju cocktail. So we have soju, but I forgot to buy the yogurt drink, so I kind of made my own. I took sparkling lemon soda and a little bit of my leftover kombucha in guava, and then I mixed it with my Siggy's coconut yogurt. I don't know how it tastes, but let's give it a try. It's pretty good, actually. It's a little bitter, I think. Next time I'll have to get like, I think like lemon lime soda, like Sprite, would be a lot better, but it's not bad! Not bad! Try it.
It's actually not bad. No. I could taste the guava.
Yeah. Mmm. Yeah. Wow. Actually, it's not bad.
Not bad.
Oh, good.
I'm surprised you made it. Wow.
Thank you for joining me on my Korean feast weekend. I hope you enjoyed it, and to many more feasts to come. Bye!